So there are two species of sturgeon in California. One is the green sturgeon. They are currently listed as threatened under the Endangered Species Act through the federal ESA. And then there are white sturgeon, which are currently a candidate species under the California Endangered Species Act.
The white sturgeon are the largest freshwater fish we have in California. Adults can reach up to 20 feet long at 1,500 pounds. Typically in California, our fish are quite a bit smaller than that, but it's not unusual to have 4 to 6 foot long fish, even some 7 or 8 foot long fish occasionally. Sturgeon are one of the oldest species in California with fossil records dating back over 200 million years to the early Cretaceous period. So for reference, that's over 100 million years before Tyrannosaurus rex roamed the earth. So sturgeon range from the northern border of California. They're in some of the estuaries and bays up in Northern California, but the primary population is in the California Delta, Sacramento, San Joaquin Rivers, San Francisco Bay areas. So a lot of things have led to the decline of white sturgeon. The Central Valley is one of the most heavily human influenced systems that we have. There's a lot of dams, rivers have been levied, we've had a lot of habitat loss. So that's contributed a significant amount. In addition, we also have had over-harvest in the sport fishery in certain years. Sturgeon are a very heavily poached species because their caviar is so valuable. So those have all led to the declines. In addition, recently we've had what's called a harmful algal bloom. Our most recent population estimates show that we've seen about an 80% decline in the number of white sturgeon over the last 25 years. So we have significant concerns about the health of this population.
Currently, the fishery for green sturgeon is closed, and white sturgeon with the listing have changed from harvest opportunity to catch and release only. Sturgeon are long-lived. They have a very slow growth rate, and they are species that get caught again and again and again. They don't spawn once and then die, and they can live 50 to 100 years. Removing harvest but allowing catch and release is going to give the population time to rebound, and we may be able in the long run to see population growth. In order to make informed management decisions, both for conservation and the fishery, the department needs to get out and monitor the species. Recently, we've been able to set up a monitoring program that partnering with Pacific States Marine Fisheries Commission and local fishing industry to get out and help us monitor these species, catch these species, tag them, so we can get a better idea of how many there are in the population. For an angler to come out and to be able to catch a sturgeon, I think is a very unique and exciting experience. Because they are this prehistoric, very dinosaur looking fish, for someone who's pulling up a fish that's 4 to 8 feet long, it is probably gonna be a thrill. Even if they aren't at this time able to take that fish home, they're going to have had that experience to see one of these fish and be able to take a photo with it, release it, and know that that fish is going to live a lot longer and be able to produce more fish in the future.